Kia ora. A couple of weeks ago, I posted a video about the government's proposed water reform package and other changes currently underway. A lot of people are asking us about water reform, so here's a bit more detail about what's proposed and what our council is doing. Firstly, what are the three waters? They're the everyday water services that council provide for households right around the country. Drinking and household water, the wastewater or sewage that we take away and treat, and the rainfall runoff that's piped away and discharged into the environment. For most people in Waikerekere, Selwyn, these services are provided by our council. The water assets we look after on behalf of our community are worth $610 million. Our water charges are among the cheapest and our infrastructure the newest in the country. The government is proposing to change this system. They're proposing to hand over responsibility for these water services to four new entities. In Selwyn would be part of Entity D, which covers most of the South Island. So why is the government proposing this change? First, the evidence suggests that many councils have underspent on water infrastructure over the years, so they're left with old, unreliable networks. Many smaller councils would struggle to be able to afford their upgrades they'll need to get their systems up to scratch. Enforcement of environmental and water quality standards is increasing too, and this could result in huge cost increases for many councils. The government's suggesting the new entities would be better placed to borrow the funds needed to invest in these future upgrades, and they also think the costs for householders would be lower under the proposed reform. But there's still things we haven't been told, and we've got a lot of questions about the proposal. Right now, there's too many unknowns for us to make an informed decision on whether or not to support the proposal. Plus, we want to make sure you get the opportunity to have a say in the proposed reforms. So what are we doing about it? First, we're asking for more information. We want to know more about the future cost projections and how they've been calculated. We want to know how the local community's voice will be protected. We want to know who sets the priorities for investment, how will the partnership with Mana Whenua work, and when will local communities get a chance to have their say in the proposals. Along with other Canterbury councils, we're also calling for a pause in the process so everyone can get the information they need. If the government keeps the option for councils to stay in or opt out of reform, we hope this will mean we can consult more widely with you before the end of the year. In the meantime, we've provided some information to help you understand what's been proposed and what council's up to. Check out our article in this week's Selwyn Times or visit the Three Waters webpage on council's website. We all want to know what happens next, and that's in the government's hands. We'll keep you updated as we find out more. Ka kite anō.